Tiffany here with Years of Years, and it's This Day in Disney for October 8th. And starting off, we're headed to 1945, and with the unfortunate passing of Felix Salten. He passed away at the age of 76 in Zurich, Switzerland, and he is most well known and famous for his work Bambi, A Life in the Woods, which was he wrote or finished in 1923. So he was a prolific writer in Vienna in the early 1900s and produced an average of one book a year of plays, short stories, novels, travel books, essays, and collections. And in 1927, he actually became the president of the Pen Club, or P-E-N Club, and that club actually, I looked it up, has been going for almost 100 years. It's on its 99th year, so that's really cool. And it's there to promote friendship and intellectual cooperation amongst writers, and it was co-founded by Amy Dawson Scott all the way back then. Salten's most famous work was Bambi, which we know and are, if you've read Bambi, I don't know if you've read it, the book, but I really enjoyed this book, and of course we love it because of the film Bambi. So he was an avid hunter, so he was well equipped to write Bambi. It was translated in 1928 and became a Book of the Month Club hit. In 1933, he actually sold the film rights to Sidney Franklin for $1,000, who actually later transferred the rights to Walt Disney. So Disney Studios released Bambi in 1942, so just a couple years before he passed away. But that's not it. He actually wrote the story Perri and The Hound of Florence. So that inspired more Disney films. The film Perri was based off of Perri, and the Shaggy dog was based off the Hound of Florence. So you'll have to go check those out. I know the Shaggy dog is on Disney Plus because we watched it. It's really cute, but it's very different from the book. And as far as Bambi goes, the book and the film are very different. So if you haven't read the book, I definitely encourage you to read it. I found it very interesting and a very emotional book. Very well written, and something that I look forward to reading again someday. I enjoyed it so much. And of course, we love Bambi a lot in this family. I think it's one of Miles's favorite films, so one we love to watch. Next up on This Day in Disney, back in 1975, I thought this was just really interesting. The best of Walt Disney's True Life Adventures, which those True Life Adventures were award-winning, well-loved, and received. So they were compiled into a film that was released in theaters called The Best of Walt Disney's True Life Adventures. And it was released by Buena Vista, and it debuted, and the film highlights like Seal Island, Beaver Valley, Nature's Half Acre, and Waterbirds. Some of those you can watch on Disney Plus now separately. If you wanted to see this entire film, you need to watch it on Amazon Prime or YouTube. But it was interesting. It was released in 1975, and then it was actually released on VHS in the United Kingdom in the 1980s, but never released on VHS in America. So we don't have it, but you can try and go find it. Really interesting that they compiled it together and that people could go watch it in the theaters. So I just thought that was a cool tidbit of history, and neat how they were providing something like that. It wasn't like an original release. They were recompiling all these great True Life Adventures. Really awesome. So if you haven't seen those, go watch them. So that's it for This Day in Disney. I hope you have a great day.